Two of the architects of the operation kept a watchful eye on proceedings. And a well-known soldier boarded a naval vessel early in the affair. The Luftwaffe was not entirely absent. Heavy supplies were landed quickly on the beaches. And men kept pouring in. The unloading went on swiftly. The air forces, flying low, continued to find targets on the roads and railway lines. On fields inland, the gliders had landed and discharged their cargo. More and more men were put ashore, more material. German fire brought down Allied soldiers, but others kept on. Craft sank in the rough sea, and many rescues were effected. Fires dotted the battlefield, but the work of securing the beachhead went on. In from the coast, the infantry pushed ahead, forcing the enemy back. Tanks rolled up to support the advance. Civilians came out from their shelters to greet the liberating army. Savage street fighting took place at many points. This was part of the West Wall, and these were some of its defenders. Troops worked their way in, collecting prisoners on the roadside.